Okay, runners, I am going to start talking, hoping for the best. Real quick, I want to talk about early running and training in January. Obviously we're all getting kicked off for 2021. So I want to make sure that you guys know where you should be at right now. So real quick, before I get going, like always, I want to tell you about something that's going on. This Tuesday, I don't even know what the date is. It's like 1/5, maybe January 5th. I put a link in the post to, if you want to come to my first ever fireside chat, where I'll be talking all about 2021 running and training. So be sure to click on the link in this post. It's a free training that I'm doing just right on Facebook Live, fireside chat without any fire. So it's just going to be me talking with another individual. So the link is in this post. You can set a reminder for that. So be sure to do that. What I want to talk about today is how to make January, February kind of set you up for the rest of the year. Leading up to the new year, I talked about, your goal should be to be injury free this year. But let's talk about some different scenarios. Let's make sure we're all in the right mindset to make this happen. And it is piggyback off an email that I'm going to read to you here in a minute, or someone wrote in and had a question about being injured. So if you're not injured right now and you're feeling really good and you're feeling strong, what I want to make sure that you do is stay that way. So one of the biggest things I see people make in January is a couple errors that I think if you can listen to these, will avoid any kind of injuries and offset, getting off track early before the year gets started, which is running too hard too soon. So right now, just get in the right mindset. All of you should be out running on predictable surfaces. So what does that mean? Avoid sand, avoid snow, avoid ice, and really try to take it easy. I think when you're out on a run and you're running along and if you just do a set, whenever that timer goes off on your watch for a mile or a kilometer, whatever it is you have set, take a minute. And when you hear that beep, I want you to just think, Steve wanted me to do a self-assessment. Where is my running at right now? And I want you to think, am I pushing? And if you find that you're pushing right now and you're in your run, you're like, oh, I am kind of pushing and I'm drifting towards that comfortable hard spot, be careful because that is where I see a lot of runners breaking down and having a lot of issues. You want to make sure that you're feeling like you're not pushing, that you're pulling back and things are going really well. So that's the first thing. Before I go into the next one, just a reminder, if you're just joining me, there's a link in this post to come to a free fireside chat without a fire this Tuesday. All you have to do is go to the link in this post, tap the get reminder button, and join me on Tuesday night. So the second group of people are people who we have the first group who are feeling really good in the running. The second group are people who aren't injured, but they have something going on that still lets them run. In this group, you're going to be very similar to the first one. You're going to make sure that you're taking your time, that you're not rushing it, that you are still staying easy. But I really want to make sure that you are loading up your strength. So normally I would advocate for people to be running or doing their strength workouts at least once a week, trying to get an hour in. But once or twice a week is going to be the really big spot once you're injury free. If you're feeling like you're injured, 2 to 3 times a week in dropping your mileage is super, super valuable for someone who's in between. Like, I'm running, I don't feel great, but I can still run. 3 times a week, bring your mileage down just a little bit and feed that extra time in. So normally 30 to 60 minutes, I'm saying 60 to 90 minutes a week can make a huge difference. And it could just be you not running a 3 miler and doing strength instead, which I know you don't want to do, but I do know you want to run injury free. So that is the second group. First group, running great, everything feels good, slow down. Second group, doing okay, still running, but something's bothering them. Increase your strength, bring down your mileage for the month of January. I think you're going to see a lot of improvements. Now, this third group are the groups that like, I'm not even able to run right now. And that's what this email came from. Real quick, before I go into this third group, there's a link in this post, free fireside chat without the fire this Tuesday night. And I just saw it will be recorded for afterwards. But if you want to get any live questions in, if we might do a giveaway, you have to be present during the live event. So click on the link in the post, tap the get reminder button, and just watch me on Facebook some more. So the third group are the group that's not running anymore. So I got a link, an email today that someone said, let me just find it here. I'm 48 and I have battled chronic hamstring pulls and tears for about 2 to 3 years. The hamstring issues have caused me to completely stop running for the last 3 months. I'm very much looking forward to doing things right with the proper running specific strength training and build up for the return to running. So what do you do if you're in this situation? I can't even run. Like, I have something going on. I'm sore and I'm not able to get going again. My big thing here is hang in there. The body is amazing at healing itself. You just have to make sure you're doing the right things. What I would recommend doing is being very, very consistent on strength training. So 3, 4 times a week, you can do core every single day. get your core strength up, get your glute strength up, get your balance up, as long as it doesn't aggravate your symptoms. And if it doesn't aggravate your symptoms, keep doing that. We have a system in the Run Smart app that is called the Injury Management Protocol, which is the protocol I pretty much use no matter the injury. And when someone can't run, I put them on the bike, I put them on the elliptical, I put them doing any kind of cardiovascular exercise that doesn't feel like crap and doesn't aggravate their injury, because what that allows you to do is not only sweat a little bit so you feel good, but it also allows you to feed blood to the injured areas and help it heal a little bit faster. The strength training, you are just gonna load that sucker up. Don't make yourself too sore, but you should be doing strength 4 or 5 times a week, cardio 3 to 4 times a week, if you really are serious about getting in back into running. You can decrease that. That's someone who is probably running a little bit more mileage, but minimum 3 times a week, you should be hitting your strength training. And I'm confident if you're patient, you give it 4, 8 weeks, depending on how long out you've been. This guy's been battling this for 3 months, so it's not unreasonable to ask for maybe 2 months to get yourself back. 3 months injured, 2 months of recovery. That happens sometimes, especially depending on the injury. So those are the 3 categories. Real quick, I'll give it to me again. You can watch the video again to figure out what I said. The first group, you're feeling great, slow down. That's the moral of that story. Second group, you're okay, you're running, but you don't feel great. Increase your strength, bring down your mileage a little bit. Third group, you're not running that well. You're really not running at all because you're injured. Ramp up your strength training, bring up your cardio, and give it at least 4 to 8 weeks to get back into running. Thanks for joining me tonight. Again, there's a link in this post to my first ever fireside chat without any fire, just sitting in a chair talking to you, answering your questions and talking about how to make 2021 great. You can click the link in this post, tap the get reminder button so you don't miss it. And I'll talk to you guys soon. Let me know if you have any questions in the comments. April, hang in there. He says that you're still in the third group, which is injured. Be patient, do the right stuff. You can break through. All right, everyone, have a great night. I'll talk to you soon.